Welcome to my lesson on locomotive maintenance. First, you need to know that all locomotives have different maintenance intervals and consumption depending on their type. Look at the rail line between Sacramento and San Francisco. See the current state of the locomotive. The lower the condition is, the more often the train has a breakdown and stops on the way. Locomotives are automatically repaired at stations if they have a maintenance depot. To do this, try choosing the station in Sacramento. You can select Construct Extension. Do that and take a look at the options available. Then build a main. Very good! Whenever the state bar of a locomotive has dropped to about 60%, it will be serviced. And since the Sacramento station is used by both of your train lines, the maintenance depot also benefits both train lines. Now close the station again and select a train line once more. These three bars show the levels of water, sand, and oil. If operating materials are missing, the locomotive will be significantly slower. Water is needed on a daily basis. Sand is needed when going uphill to increase the friction of the wheels. Oil is needed to lubricate moving parts, and the amount required is dependent upon the distance traveled. All of the operating materials that a locomotive requires can be obtained at supply towers, which must be built along the tracks. Open the building menu and select the supply tower. Now build a supply tower near each of the marked positions. Good. Both rail lines can now reach a supply tower. You can build them at any position along your lines, but they should be far enough away from switches and stations so that a long train can stop at them without creating conflicts. There is one more building that has to do with maintenance, the maintenance post. Select this building type. Unlike the maintenance depot or the supply tower, the maintenance post is not a required building type. It is suitable, however, when many trains come together in a small space because the maintenance post can reduce breakdowns and thus long traffic jams and conflicts considerably. However, This also results in deaths. This brings us to the end of this lesson. Feel free to look around some more. Once you have finished, this tutorial will end. This lesson is about optimizing rail lines, specifically how to optimize the revenue of a rail line according to its tasks. For this purpose, select a train of the rail line from Sacramento to San Francisco. Since this rail line operates between two cities, it transports passengers and mail. These two goods are among the express goods because they require fast transportation. Consequently, the faster the transport, the higher the transport revenue. For example, the faster you transport a passenger, the higher the ticket revenue. Now, open the balance sheet of the rail line. Here you can see, among other information, what revenues the selected train had on its last full tour. As you can see, revenue for freight transportation also plays a role. While Sacramento produces meat, San Francisco has cloth. Fixed prices are paid for freight transportation, so speed is not a factor here. Now consider the costs. Maintenance and fuel are mainly affected by the length of a tour, but personnel generates daily costs, so speed plays a factor here. Also, a rail line can transport more if it is faster. However, freight is much, much heavier than express goods, and a locomotive cannot be fast and powerful at the same time. Therefore, there are different locomotives. For example, on this rail line, a mixed-use locomotive is used. This is always good if the load consists of at most half freight goods. If there is a higher percentage of freight, a freight locomotive would be better, because the train will otherwise be very slow, even on slight inclines. We now want to test a freight locomotive and one for express goods between the two cities. Open the research and development section. Here you will see many technologies that you can unlock over the years. They improve countless aspects of your business. These include higher ticket prices, happier passengers, and even more modern locomotives. Your current locomotive is the Dunham. Select it and let's take a look at its data. Compare the speed, tractive power, and suitability of the Dunham with the two locomotives to the right of the Dunham, the Derwent and the Firefly. You can see that the fast Firefly has a much lower tractive power than the powerful Derwent. This means that the Firefly is much worse at pulling heavy loads, but much faster at pulling light loads. Now, unlock these two locomotives so you can use them in your rail line. Very good. Now close this dialogue. Now optimize the rail line for express goods. Exchange the locomotive for the Firefly and select express as the load type. Then pay the cost for the new locomotives and close this dialogue. Now, watch your rail line and use the fast forward function if you like. It will only pick up express goods and it will reach a much higher speed than before. After a while, it will even show the express symbol. This means your rail line is the fastest of its time and gets even higher ticket revenue. You don't have to offer an express line, of course. Everything works with slower and mixed transports as well. But suppose you have a good reason for this optimization. Then, of course, freight transport is missing. If you can't transport freight on the same tracks, that would slow down the express train. Therefore, you should expand the tracks from Sacramento to San Francisco. To do this, extend the two parallel tracks from Sacramento to San Francisco by two more tracks. Then build a station gridiron at each station, connecting each of the four tracks. You can just build the new station gridiron on top of the previous one, but be aware that the new gridiron is much longer. Don't forget the directions for the new tracks. Excellent. Now create a new rail line from Sacramento to San Francisco. To make it use the new tracks, you need to set waypoints. To do this, select the following four objects in sequence: Sacramento, the outbound track, San Francisco, the return track. Very good. Now use the Derwent as the locomotive. Select freight to be loaded because this rail line should only carry freight. That's exactly how it's done. Normally, trains always take the shortest way. But by using waypoints, you can specify certain paths. You should also do this for your express line, so that the two lines don't get in each other's way. Otherwise, we're through with this lesson, so when you're ready, you can finish it. Greetings! This lesson is about how you can recognize the needs of a city and use them to your advantage. I'll also show you how to invest in the production of goods to ensure additional transport and growing cities, which in turn leads to even more transport. Open the city dialog of Sacramento and then the supply and demand list. This list shows you, among other things, how high the stock of all goods is, and how high the current demand by citizens and factories is. As an example, look at grain. The city needs grain, yet the supply is at zero. This is because the nearest grain farm is too far away and is virtually unsupplied by traditional transportation. The same is true for lumber. So with the help of new rail lines, we could improve the goods coverage of the city. For corn, however, there is some supply. Here, a corn farm is nearby and goods are transported via road. A new rail line would generate revenue, but would not improve the city's fulfillment of demand until the city has grown too large for traditional transportation. Now, close the list again and look for suitable businesses to improve the city's fulfillment of demand so that the city can grow. To the north of Sacramento, there is lumber, and in the northeast, there is grain available. Now build a station at both farms and connect them to Sacramento, preferably with double tracks and a gridiron.